Hello students, the subject for today is mathematics and the topic is shares and dividends. Before moving ahead with the sums, let us first clear the important terms for the chapter. First of all, we need to understand what do we mean by a share. Share is basically a unit of the capital invested into a company. That is, whenever one wishes to open a company, he invests a particular amount. When that particular amount is divided into different parts or proportion, each of such part or a unit is called a share. Let us understand this with a simple example. Say A wishes to open a company and he wants to invest rupees 50. Now A along with other 9 people comes together. Each of them contribute rupees 5. So 5 into 10 gives you 50. So your 50 becomes the total investment. 5 rupees paid by each person is termed to be as the face value or the nominal value. And here each person is contributing the capital. So here each person is termed to be as the shareholder, having one share each. Okay. Next term here is then market value. Sometimes the shares are purchased from the shareholders from the market and market keeps on fluctuating. Therefore, sometimes the value may rise and sometimes the value may fall. Therefore, the price at which the shareholder purchases the share from the market is called as market value. Now here, don't get confused between nominal value or the face value and the market value. Nominal and face value does not change. It is decided by the company, whereas market value keeps on changing. Sometimes it may rise and sometimes it may fall. Now, when the market value increases, that is, it is higher than your face value. Let us take an example. For example, the nominal value of one share is rupees 10, but it is available in the market for rupees 12, means that it is higher than rupees 10 by rupees 2. The person purchasing it from the market will have to pay 2 rupees extra, and that is called as premium. And say case 2, wherein the same share, that is 10 rupee face value, is available in the market at rupee 8. So here it is, the value is less than what the face value offers. So here the person is purchasing it for a lesser price in the market, and it is called as at discount. And if the person purchases the share at a value equivalent to the face value, means in the market the value of the share is also 10 and the face value is also 10. So here the share is considered to be at par. So premium means higher than the face value, discount means lower than the face value, and at par means the market value and the face value are equal. Next is dividend. Dividend is basically a part of a profit which is distributed among the shareholders as dividend. It's a kind of a return which the shareholder is getting when he invests his money into the company. It depends on the company at which rate they are offering you the dividend. It could be 5%, 10%, 15%. It varies from question to question. Two things we need to understand here is that the dividend depends upon the face value. That is, though the market value may rise, may fall or remain at par, but the dividend does not change as dividend is dependent upon the face value. So if a share has the as rupees 100 and say the rate of dividend is 12%, then the person will get rupees 12 as dividend irrespective of the market prices. So hope the concepts are clear. Now we need to move forward with the formula. So here the first formula is money invested. So money invested in simpler terms is number of shares into the market value of one share. Now if say the question states that the price of one share available in the market is rupees 20 and the number of shares that the person wants to buy is 100. So it will be simply be 100 into 20, that is 2000. We will not multiply it with the face value. it may be 10, it may be 15. We always calculate money invested considering the market value, because we are actually going to pay the market value, not the face value. Next is annual income. Annual income is basically what we are getting in return from the money that we have invested in the shares. It is calculated on the rate of dividend. It is very simple. It is rate of dividend into the number of shares into the face value. So say my share has a face value of 100 and the rate of dividend is 15%. So 15 upon 100 into 100, that gives me rupees 15. Now this is the dividend which I'm getting on one share. I have say 100 share. So 15 into 100 shares will give me 1500. So this is the way we need to find out the dividend. Please keep in mind that rate of dividend is always calculated on the face value irrespective of the market value. Next is return percentage. It is simply annual income upon the investment into 100%. Return percentage into the market value is equal to that of rate of dividend into face value. You need to understand that return percentage is always calculated on the market value and the rate of dividend is always calculated on the face value. And the answer which you get by calculating is always equal. Next is number of share purchased. Again, you could use the first formula itself to calculate the number of share purchased. It simply becomes the total money that you're investing divide by the market value of one share will give you the number of shares. Now let us understand how to calculate dividend. In the first case, 180 shares of rupees 50 each paying 12% dividend is given. Now in this case, let us take rupees 50 as our face value, as nothing else is mentioned, and 12% is a rate of dividend. So as per the formula, rate of dividend into the face value into the number of shares, which means 12 upon 100 into rupees 50 into 180 simply gives you rupees 1080. So here 1080 rupees becomes our dividend. Similarly, in the second case, 424 shares are available at rupees 125 giving 8% dividend. So again, it simply is 8 upon 100 into 125 into 424, that will give you 4240 rupees. And in the next case, 60 shares of rupees 100 each available at rupees 75 and paying 5% dividend. Now here we need to understand that there are two prices given for the share. One is rupees 100 and the second they've written is available at rupees 75, means that now in the market the value of the given share is 75 but the face value is 100. So it's a simple trick. Please don't get confused. I've already stated that dividend is always calculated on the face value. So here the market value is 75, but this is of no concern to us because we only need to find out the dividend, and the dividend is calculated on face value. So what we're simply going to do is 5% into 100, that is the face value, into number of shares, that is 60. And the answer that we get is rupees 300. And the fourth one, 120 shares of rupees 50 each available at rupees 62 paying 13% dividend. Again, the same thing. Here two prices are given. One is 50, that is your face value, and the second is 62, that it is your market value, showing that it is available at premium, that is 12 rupees higher. But we don't have to consider that as we are calculating dividend. So we will only be taking 13% into 50, that is the face value, into 120, which gives you rupees 780 as the dividend. Now let us move forward calculating some solved questions. The first one here is, Ramesh buys rupees 100 shares at rupees 20 premium. So means rupees 100 shares means this is the face value. So each share has a face value of rupees 100. But Ramesh is buying it at premium, means he is purchased it from a market at a higher price by 20. So therefore the price at which Ramesh has purchased, that is your market value, will be equal to 100 plus 20, that is 120. And the dividend he is getting on the shares is 15%. You need to first find out the market value of 600 shares. So this we've already calculated. 100, that is the face value, and 20, this is the premium, that is more amount that he is paid. So it's 100 plus 20 is 120. And for 600 shares, it will be simply 600 into 120 each, and that gives you rupees 72,000. Next, his annual income. Now, income here means what he is getting in return, that is the dividend. Again, repeating, dividend is calculated on the face value. So here, despite the market value is 120, we are not considering that. Face value is 100. So rate of dividend 15% into the face value, that is 100, into the number of shares, that is 600. Which is simply 15% into 100 into 600, which gives you rupees 9,000. And the next is his percentage income, that is the return percentage, which I've already mentioned in the section of formulae, which states income, that is the total income upon the total investment into 100. So total income we get is 9,000. Total investment that we have made is 72,000 into 100 gives us 12.5%. Sum number 2. A man wants to buy 62 shares available at rupees 132, par value being rupees 100. Par value means the face value or the nominal value is rupees 100. But it is available in the market at rupees 132. It means that it is at a premium of rupees 32. That is, we are paying 32 rupees more. And the number of shares is 62. So how much he will have to invest? That is 132 into the number of shares, that is 62, simply gives us rupees 8,184. Next, if the dividend is 7.5%, what will be his annual income? Again, dividend is calculated on the face value. So 7.5% into 100 into number of shares, that is 62, it gives you rupees 465. Next, if he wants to increase his annual income by rupees 150, how many extra shares would he have to buy? So here the man is willing to earn more of rupees 150 as his income. So means he will have to buy more shares. Now how do we calculate that? We know the total income extra he wants, that is rupees 150. We know the rate of dividend. We know the face value. So the only thing we need to find is number of shares. So using the dividend formula, that is 7.5% into the face value, that is rupees 100, into the number of shares will be equal to 150. Now since we here don't know the number of shares, we will simply put it as X. So it gives us as answer as 20. So means the man will have to buy more of 20 shares to increase his annual income by 150. Moving ahead to the third solved question. Dividend of 9% was declared on rupee 100 share selling at a certain price. I mean, there is a share which has a face value as 100 and the rate of dividend as 9% is being sold at a certain price. Means here we don't know the market price, but we know the rate of return, that is 7.5%. You need to find out the market value. Now here two things are given, two different rates are given. One is dividend and the other is rate of return. Already mentioned that dividend is calculated on face value and rate of return is calculated on the market value. And both of them give you the same answer. That is, the income which we will get by using either of them will be same. So simply I can say that 9% into 100 will be equal to 7.5% of the market value. Here, since we don't know what is the market value, let us take it as X. So the answer, 9% of 100 will give me rupees 9. So 7.5 upon 100 into X equal to 9. Therefore, the market value amounts to rupees 120. Next, what they're asking is, amount to be invested to obtain an annual income or a dividend of 630. This is similar to what we've done in the last sum. That is, we know the total income that we need to get is 630 rupees. And we know the rate of dividend. We need to here now find out the total number of shares that the person should buy to get that sufficient amount of income. So using the formula, number of shares is simply total income upon annual income. That is 630 is the total income. Annual income, that is the income he is going to get from each share, that is rupees 9, that is the dividend amount, which gives you 70. And now the total investment is again simply the number of shares into the market value. So number of shares is 70, market value is 120, which gives you rupees 8400 as the total investment. Now let us take the next example. Which is a better investment? There are two cases: A, 12% of rupees 100 shares, or B, 8% of rupees 100 shares at 90. Here both of them have the face value as 100, so means the face value is the same, and since number of shares is not given, so we consider it as 1-1. The only difference here is the rate of dividend. So without calculation also we can give the answer that of course case A will give us more returns as compared to that of B, because the rate of dividend in case of A is higher as compared to the rate of dividend in case B. Okay, in case of here, the face value would have been different. Say 12% of 150 rupees share and 8% of 200 share. So here you could not directly state the answer that since A has 12%, so that will fetch more return. No, because the face value are different. So you will then have to calculate by applying the dividend formula, that is rate of dividend into face value into number of share. And that way you could calculate which investment is better than the other. Next question is, a company with 4000 shares of the nominal value 110 each. So here the face value or nominal value is 110 and the number of shares is 4000. Declares annual dividend of 15%. So rate of dividend is 15%. We need to calculate the total amount of dividend paid by the company. It's very easy applying the dividend formula. 15% into 110, that is your face value or nominal value, into 4000, which gives you rupees 66,000. Okay, next, the annual income of Shahrukh, who holds 88 shares. Now again, there's a person, he has 88 shares. So again, applying the dividend formula, 15 upon 100 into 110, because it is the face value, into the number of shares. So here the number of shares for Shahrukh is 88. So his income will depend upon 88 shares. So here, therefore, we are taking 88 and the amount you get is rupees 1452. Next, if he received only 10% on his investment, find the price Shahrukh paid for each price. Now, it should be for each share. Now, here we don't know what is the exact price that he has paid for each share. That is, we don't know the market value. So, here we have the rate of return, that is 10%. And again, we have the rate of dividend, that is 15%, and we have the nominal value. The fourth element is missing, that is the market value, which we need to find. So let us take the market value as X. Already told you, rate of return on market value and rate of dividend on the nominal value is equal. So simply taking 10% into X will therefore be equal to 15% of 110, and your X you get is 165, that is the market value. Shahrukh will have to pay rupees 165 for each share. The next question is, John had 1000 shares of a company with a face value of rupees 40 and paying 8% dividend. He then sold some of these shares at a discount of 10%, means the market value is less than the face value, that is by 10%. Okay. And the investment proceeds, means whatever he got from selling those shares, that is some shares, he again invested into an investment, that is rupees 20 shares at a premium of 50%, which is paying a dividend of 12%. If the change in his income is 192, find the number of shares sold by him. Okay, this is a bit tricky, but again, it is very easy. Now, we will have to divide the sum into two parts. First, we will have to calculate the actual dividend he was getting from the first investment. And then we need to find out that after selling, when he reinvested some of the shares, what was the dividend he is getting on the second case. and then we need to find out the difference, that is by subtracting both of them the income changes 192. Okay, so let us first find out the total dividend he was getting from the first case. So let the number of shares he has sold be X. Number of shares is 1000, market value is 40, dividend he is getting is 8%. So dividend is simply 8%, that is 8/100 into the face value, that is 40, into the number of shares that he has sold. So let us take it as X. So therefore the dividend on those X shares from the first investment will be rupees 3.20 into X. Okay, now they say that he has sold these shares at a discount of 10%. So means the original value was 40, and from the market he's got it at discount. So 10% of the 40, that is 4. So 40 minus 4, that is rupees 36. So the market value of the share is rupees 36. So the total amount he would have received is market value into number of shares, that is 36x. Now in the second case, he has reinvested that amount. So the total money he has to invest is 36x. Okay. Now nominal value of each share is at premium, by 50% premium. So the actual value is rupees 20. He's been selling it at he has purchased it at premium. So 20 into 50%, okay, that will give you 10, that is the premium amount. So face value, that is 20, 20 plus 10 gives you rupees 30. Number of shares that he may then purchase will be total investment divided by the market value, which you already studied in the first part, that is the formula section. Total investment divided by the face value or the market value of each share gives us the number of shares. So the total investment here is 36x, the market value is 30, which gives us 6x divided by 5. Okay, now we need to find out the dividend. So dividend is calculated on the face value. So face value is 20, rate of dividend is 12%. So 12/100 into 20 into the number of shares, that is 6x by 5, gives you 2.88x. okay, so this is the return which you are getting from the second investment, and 3.20x was the return which we were getting from the first investment. Subtracting both of them will give us 192, which is mentioned in the question. Therefore X is equal to 600. Therefore it means that John had sold 600 shares and then he had reinvested and he got some dividend which was less enough than what he would have got when he chose not to sell his shares. And the next we are going to discuss is about tax. So rate of tax is an amount that you need to deduct from the total income that you've generated from your investment. So say whatever income that you get by calculating the dividend percentage, then you need to again apply the tax percentage and deduct the amount from the total income, that will become your net income. Let us take this example. Number of shares is 500, nominal value is 125. So therefore the total investment here becomes 125 into 500, that gives you rupees 62,500. Rate of dividend is 12%, so it is very simple, 12/100 into 125 into 500, that will give you rupees 7,500. Now you need to find out the rate of net income. So the rate of tax is given 5%. As I already told you, it will be calculated on your annual income. So 5/100 into 7,500, it gives you rupees 375. So this is the tax that you will have to pay, and that is going to be deducted from your income. So your income is 7,500, tax is 375, so you will subtract it from 7,500 and the answer you get is rupees 7,125. So this is the actual income that you will receive in your hand and called as net income. So here we conclude the chapter. Thank you.